I suppose we all thought that, one way or another.
The atom bomb made science fiction respectable to the general public. Writers felt like they were no longer free to experiment with wacky ideas. There was a new pressure to take the advancements of technology seriously and focus on the dangers of the near future. Isaac Asimov called this new type of writing tomorrow fiction. He said, "There can be nothing duller than tomorrow's headlines in science fiction." Perhaps he was intimidated by the new wave of writers who would go on to define the genre. The golden age of science fiction began in 1939 with A.E. Van Vogt's Black Destroyer, published in Astounding SF, which would go on to inspire the Alien franchise. Other notable examples from this era include Theodore Sturgeon's Microcosmic God, which introduced the idea of a pocket universe, later adapted into a Simpsons episode. There was also Isaac Asimov's Foundation series, which popularized the idea of galactic empires with feudal structures, akin to emperors and knights. Harlan Ellison, editor of Dangerous Visions and writer of the most acclaimed Star Trek episode, wrote that A.E. Van Vogt was the first writer to shine a light on the restricted ways in which I had been taught to view the universe and the human condition. He, like Philip K. Dick and J.G. Ballard and Kurt Vonnegut, would go on to lift ideas from the Golden Age and weave them into morbid dystopias. So was the dropping of the atom bomb a bad thing for science fiction? Asimov said that prior to 1945, science fiction had been wild and free. All its motifs and plot varieties remained in the realm of fantasy, and we could do as we pleased. After 1945, there came the increasing need to mold all the infinite scope of our thoughts to the small bit of them that had become real. The main complaint about the era immediately following the Golden Age, sometimes called the Second Golden Age and then the New Wave era, was it lacked adventure. Space operas, with intergalactic battles and stories about a chosen one, were replaced with explorations of psychology and sexuality. It also segued into discussions about race and feminism. I strongly recommend The Female Man by Joanna Russ, and Anything by Samuel R. Delaney. The adventure aspect would be revived by George Lucas with Star Wars, but never again would science fiction return to the optimism of the Golden Age. Asimov, like many other writers of his day, saw technology as a means to a brighter future. J.G. Ballard and Philip K. Dick saw it as something that would complicate life in frightening ways. Whether it's a good thing for our vision of the future to be warped by their pessimistic outlooks, might be a fitting subject for another science fiction novel.